liftoff.
I think the biggest thing that people probably don't know about $2 bills is that they've been in space.
We have a roll program initiated.
My name is Richard Jurek, collector of the world's largest collection of space-flown $2 bills.
Roger, understand.
These $2 bills were taken by the astronauts within their own personal preference kits. These were their choice to take with as either good luck talismans or mementos, or they had some sort of personal attachment to this $2 bill. And as such, spanning both Mercury, Gemini, and Apollo, it spans the entire length of the U.S. human spaceflight program. The first $2 bill that I'm aware of happened on John Glenn's famous orbital flight during the Mercury program in the 1960s. These bills were not taken by the astronaut on the mission, but the ground support crew secreted these bills aboard the spacecraft by wrapping them around the spacecraft wiring and signing little good luck wishes on the bill. Given that it was the first time an American orbited the Earth, I guess they felt like John needed just that little bit of extra good luck for the mission. And then when it came back to Earth, John Glenn not only signed the bill, but so did Scott Carpenter, who is the backup pilot for this mission. So the next flight that we're aware of that a $2 bill flew into space was the last Mercury flight with Gordon Cooper. That trip made 22 orbits of the Earth, and so Gordo took a $2 bill to symbolize the 22 orbits of his mission. This is a 1917 large format $2 bill. And what's unique about this bill is he folded it into eighths and tucked it into his spacesuit pocket. So this bill was actually on his person for all 22 orbits of his flight. I would think, given the uniqueness of this bill, because normal $2 bills were available at the time, that this bill had special meaning to Gordon Cooper, and that's why he took it with him.
Roger, Clay 7, reading you loud and clear.
It then followed up with Gus Grissom and John Young on the first flight of the Gemini program, where it was the first time that two astronauts flew into space, thus the $2 bill that flew with on that mission. And then on the following mission, on Gemini 4, a $2 bill flew with Jim McDivitt for the first time an American did a spacewalk when Ed White opened the capsule and went out into space. That $2 bill was exposed to the vacuum of space for the first time. I consider this $2 bill the most unique $2 bill on the planet. This is Gene Cernan's good luck $2 bill that flew on all three of his space missions. And his father used to keep this $2 bill in his wallet, and he would take it to work all the time, and he took it for good luck. So when his son, Gene Cernan, went into space for the first time on Gemini 9, he gave Gene this $2 bill for good luck, and Gene took it with him, and it meant a lot to him. And it's an interesting historical fact that Gene almost died on that mission during his spacewalk. He almost didn't come back into the capsule. This bill was aboard Apollo 10, and Apollo 10 flew within just a few miles of the lunar surface. And with him, on his person, Gene had this $2 bill for good luck. And he and his co-pilot, Tom Stafford, accidentally flipped the wrong switch. And for just a few seconds, the lunar module was out of control in lunar orbit, and they almost crashed and died. But being the pros that they were, they instantly got control of their ship and they came back. So think about that. Gene now has a $2 bill that has practically saved his life not once, but twice. So when Gene was selected as the last man to walk on the moon for the Apollo lunar program, he took that $2 bill with him, not only into Earth orbit, not only into lunar orbit, but down onto the surface of the moon with him. And sure enough, he came back safely.
That's beautiful.
And Gene Cernan assigned the bill. This bill is worn for many reasons. It's probably the furthest traveled $2 bill on the planet.
This note is the crown jewel in a collection of 11 bills that Richard features in a virtual museum at jeffersonspacemuseum.com. Richard would not state what he paid for the bills, but he has received several six-figure offers for the collection. This is due in large part because, based on where they've been and who signed them, these $2 bills actually are rare.